channel, Dr. Mary Mugu, where we affect lives, we affect businesses, and we affect the society. If you have not subscribed, please do. This channel will help you in life. It will help you in business. Great. Today, I want to talk about bullying. Hello, bullying. You know, bullying happens every day, everywhere, and to many of us, and probably to all of us who are listening today. Bullied, students are bullying each other, parents are bullying their children, children are bullying their parents. And so today I want to talk about bullying. Actually, in the next three videos, I want to talk about bullying, because you must stop bullying. What is bullying? Now, when you talk about bullying, you're talking about the repeated unreasonable actions that are directed to someone. They are repeated. They are unreasonable. They are those, you know, intentional acts. The word is intentional. Someone is doing it intentionally. Intentional acts of violence that are aimed at hurting another person. Yeah? When someone is bullying you, be it a boss, be it an employee, be it another student, the reasons why people bully you is because they want to intimidate you. They want to belittle you. They want to show you don't know anything. They want to emulate you in front of others. And by the way, bullying is lack of respect. It is lack of responsibility towards others. So if you are bullying, it is time to stop, because that is lack of respect. That is lack of responsibility. Yeah? In the working place, bullying is a deviant workplace behavior. Yeah? And bullying can be in form of personal attitudes. There are people with ATT, you know? Have you heard about ATT? Personal attitude. It can be a physical threat. Sometimes it can be unwarranted criticism. You know these guys who criticize you for nothing? You know, we normally say it's these guys who look for flaws with a toothpick. Irrespective of how good you do things, they must look for something. Bullying, unwarranted criticism. Sometimes there are those funny jokes, which sometimes can even be ratio. Unajua nyinyi watu wa inside, unafanyanga hivi, you know. So it can be sometimes funny jokes. From a workplace point, it can even be excessive monitoring. You know these bosses who all monitor you like hell, man. They want to know where you are, what you're doing. Excessive monitoring. Some of them will blame you without any factual evidence. They even want to jail you if possible. They want you to be taken to court with no factual evidence. Sometimes these people exclude you from what they are doing. That is bullying. If you are doing something, if even a family is doing something, and they're excluding you, hey, that's bullying. Or even when people, you know, an institution, people are doing things and they exclude you. Sometimes bullying is in the form of distortion of facts. Something has been said, hey, you distort everything so that you can bully the person. Sometimes it's yelling, screaming, or even treating other people differently from the rest. Sometimes it's verbal abuse. Or even misrepresentation. Hey, have you been bullied lately? Any of those? Yeah? Now, bullying is abuse or misuse of power against a person. But let me clarify something here. Being tough or demanding is not necessarily bullying. No. Sometimes someone may be demanding because they want results. That is not bullying. Yeah? And you need to be aware they are clever bullies. Hey, there are these people who are really respected, who are really trusted, but my friend, they betray you when necessary because they want to fulfill their ambitions. Yeah? For them, that justifies the means. So they are those two clever bullies, eh? You think they are really trusted, they are really respected, But when it is necessary, hey, they start exploiting you. Eh? A clever bully will exploit people around them. Their work is to make sure they get what they want. So for them, the end justifies the means. If you happen to have a boss who is a bully and who is toxic, hey, if you are not careful, you're gonna find yourself in hospital. You know, there are these bully bosses, eh? All they do is to humiliate you. They will never say anything good about you. They even write false evaluations. Imagine, so that you are disadvantaged. Would you believe that? Can you imagine a boss writing a false evaluation so that you don't get promoted and you are a good employee? That's a boss who is a bully. A boss can also be toxic, because a toxic boss is either a bully or incompetent. And you can check about toxic bosses and employees in my video on toxic employees and toxic bosses, an interview I did at Metropo TV. Yeah, we are talking about bullies, okay? Bullies. Now, it is good for you to understand that bully bosses are insecure and they are either sadists. If you see a boss who bullies you, they are insecure. They think, ako kakiti wako nayo, ay, lazima niweke, my friend. Eh? Or they are those who just derive pleasure when they see you suffer. Bully bosses. How do you know that you are being bullied? How would you know that someone is bullying you? Or what are the types of bully behavior? And as I mentioned these behaviors, check yourself, because most of you could be bullies and you don't know. Yes. One of the major bully behaviors is when people give you tasks that no one wants to do. Yeah? Or they request you to perform work that you have no ability to perform or below your level of competence. For example, you start giving someone who is supposed to be a HOD, you start telling them to go and arrange chairs. That is bullying. I like this, oh. Eh? When you start giving people responsibilities that either above their competence or below their competence or something nobody else wants to do, you are simply a bully. Yes. Another way you can know that someone is bullying you or a type of bullying behavior is when people request you to work for overtime without extra benefit. Those are bullies. They start telling you how you need to help the institution, how you need to help the company. What are they doing themselves? Bullies. If you work for overtime, you should be paid. Otherwise, everyone works overtime, okay? Sometimes it's when people take credit for your work. Any person who takes credit for work you have done is simply a bully. Yeah? When colleagues start spreading rumors, spreading gossip, talking about you behind your back, don't think that they don't know God. They are simply bullies. They are bullying behavior. And by the way, those kind of fellas, if they are given kacheo kidogo hivi, my friend, they will spread rumors like bushfire. Sometimes another, you can be bullied or you can tell when you are being bullied when people start making fun of you. People make fun of you for whatever reason. Others will make fun of you because of where you come from. Others will make fun of you because of the English you speak. Bullies. Yes, sometimes also you can be bullied by being blamed for things when things go wrong. When people start blaming you for things that are going wrong, just know they are bullies. You know, there are these fellas who never take responsibility over anything. They always look for someone to blame. Huh? And if they miss someone to blame the devil. Hey, you are a bully. Yeah? Sometimes people even fabricate complaints about others. Imagine, someone, they know there is nothing, but they just decide to just spoil your name, to just complain. For the simple reason, they are bullies. Others withhold information that is very relevant to what you do. Imagine, someone knows you need that information, they decide they are not giving you the information. They are simply bullies. How many bullies do you have so far? Think about yourself. Others humiliate you, they ridicule you. Yeah? You will know a boss is a bully when they start signaling that you need to resign. You know, there are those guys who tell you, hey, the way things are going, man, resign. Bullies. Yeah? Others will ignore anything that you say. Mtu ana ignore every opinion you give in the office, every opinion you give anywhere. They ignore it. Bullies. Yeah? From a working point, sometimes they give you unreasonable deadlines. My friend, unatumiwa kitu usiku, unaambiwa asubuhi utume. Ni kama unafanya kazi usiku. Bullies. Bullying behavior. I'm telling you. Have you so far realized any bully around you? Or even yourself? Be honest to yourself. Do a comment hapo chini, sema najua bully. Ama mimi ni bully. Yeah? Others, you know, or tease you as an employee. Teasing. You know, wana kutiza, wame, hey, unakaa hivi. Bullies. Okay? Yeah? Others who excessively monitor you in everything that you do. What am I saying? As you listen to me, you need to ask yourself, are you a bully or are you being bullied? Yeah? If you are bullied, stop it. If you're being bullied, stop it also. You don't have to agree to be bullied. Yeah? And especially if you are bullied, understand by bullying other people, you don't look more powerful. You look stupid. Yes. I mean, when you talk bad about people, when you do things to ridicule people, to humiliate people, to show people they don't know anything, you're not gonna be powerful. You are simply stupid. Yes. Yeah? So it is important. Now, finally for today, how do you deal with bullying in an institution or in an organization? Yeah? How do you deal with bullying? The first thing that you must do is you must resist. Yeah? Resist that urge of micromanaging employees. Resist it. Micromanaging does not mean you are in charge, and being hands-off does not mean you are not a good leader, you know? So micromanaging is not equal to hands-on. No. Resist that urge to want to excessively monitor what people are doing. Provide positive feedback to your employees, to your children. Let them know that they can make it. Let employees know when they have done well. That is a way of dealing with bullying, yeah? Foster a positive workplace, yeah? Where people feel good they work. Where people feel they feel good that they work for you. Yeah? Then encourage strong leadership. Strong and effective leadership. You know, if you are a good leader, people will follow you without you saying. Yeah? You don't have to bully people to follow you. No. And then ensure that you communicate. Communication. That is the best way to deal with bullying. Because people are not, you know, pass rumors and all those kind of things if there's communication. And of course, give sufficient resources to the staff to do their job. You don't tell people to do their work and you don't give them the resources. So what we are saying here is that you need to know, are you a bully? Do you know any bully? Hey, comment hapo chini bana. Najua huyu ni bully. But what I'm saying, stop bullying other people. Stop bullying your children. Stop bullying employees. Stop bullying anybody in your life. Because bullies will never succeed in life. Bullies will never be powerful. You can do whatever you want to do, but they won't work. Hey, by the way, all that information I'm telling you is in this book. If you want to learn more about bullying, get a copy of this book, How to Thrive and Influence Your Workplace. 1,500 shillings only. Bullying is a topic that is well covered in this book. I also have other two books which I want to interest you in. You can buy this book, Growing a Business Empire, How to Effectively Manage Leadership Succession for Organizational Growth. This is a book whose foreword is done by Dr. Manu Chandaria. Make your copy. You will not regret, especially if you have a family business, this book is for you. And then I have my first book, about 20 copies remaining, The Winning Strategy, How to Use Strategic Planning to Build Effective Organizations. All these books, a copy is 1,500. If you need a copy, we will deliver where you are. Just dial the number 0776-045-087 and you will get your copy. Yeah. So what am I saying? Stop bullying other people. It doesn't make you powerful. Okay? Like this video, share this video, and subscribe. Until next week or next time when I release something else on bullying, have a good time and God bless you. Thank you very much.